bucks or 100 in one of these apps, right, like you've said now, which are make it so easy. Do you pick like an index fund or
you
what?
Pick an index fund or... Right. You don't need to be a stock picker. In fact, it's probably better that you're not a stock picker. Right. And you just put it in an index fund. And that's the sort of habit that you're trying to develop of just doing that every month. It's not a choice. Don't make it a choice to do it or not. That's just what you do. Just do it, right.
How about the next one, which is, I'm so young, there's plenty of time later for me to think about and deal and work on all of this.
Right. So the biggest reason to not do that is the power of compounding, right? So it's not just that you're delaying the $50. It's whatever else you could be earning on that over and over and over again. And that's a really important thing to understand. So if you start to do that, even if you're really young, you'll see it so much. You'll see the compounding effects as you go on, and that's exciting. Yeah. And that sort of gets you interested in keeping that habit up. It feels good to do that.
We were talking to Tony Robbins about this yesterday, and he had some nice stats that just said, look, if you start putting money away in your 20s, you only need to do $3,200 a year to have $1 million, you know, quote unquote, mm-hmm, at retirement. You wait until you're in your 50s or 60s, you're not talking about having to do $75,000 or $150,000. So it's one of those weird things where you're saying that the younger you are, the more reason there is to do it now.
Well, Einstein said it, compounding interest is the most powerful force in the universe. So that seems like a good reason to do it.
As good as any. Yeah. Number three is, I'll start to invest when I make more money.
Right. And I hear that a lot. And it seems to make sense to people when they say it. But in reality, it's like saying, I'll go to the gym when I'm in good shape, right? It makes no sense. How you get a really lot of money is start investing when you have even a little money and then more and more and more. That's a really bad excuse.
What do you think about allocation? So do people need to worry? Let's say, okay, they've started to do this and they're going along. Do they have to start worrying about bonds and CDs and being conservative? Or are you saying just get involved with the stock market, again, broadly speaking, and don't overthink it?
That's sort of what I think, right? And I've always been a stock market person, so I love equity exposure. But I think that over time, that is the place to be. And don't overthink it. And really, don't let your emotions guide you, because when you hear, oh, the market's really bad, and so I shouldn't buy that now, that is when you should buy. So don't let your emotions get in the way. Just do it.
It's tough. And here's the final one. It's kind of the flip side of what we were talking about earlier, or goes to the point of how difficult it can be. It says, I'm too old for this to make a difference.
Right. I hear that a lot, too. And you are as young today as you will ever be for the rest of your life. And we may live a lot longer than we think we're going to live, right? So that is really not an excuse either. And it feels scary to not save and invest. It actually decreases the fear when you do start doing it. Head in the sand is not a good option.